You are now tuned in to the latest and the greatest on the Android system. This is the channel that gives you information every day and every way possible. Make sure you go ahead and you hit the like button on your way in and hit the bell as well. Subscribe. Become a member of the family. Check out the full catalog of videos I made just for you. And I'll see you right after this. Peace. Hey, what's up guys, it's your boy Serrano, and before we get started, let me give you a brief history on an emerging company called Poptel. Now, Poptel has emerged on the scene in 2018, and they are actually bringing forth phones that have military standard. So basically, they're going to be IP68 dustproof and waterproof, which is actually really cool. Without any further ado, let's just jump into the unboxing of the Poptel P10. Now, let's just take a look at the box, and you can see it's a nice, presentation right here. You can see it does have that Poptel logo in the gold color or black box here, and you can see right here, just pop that off, put that to the side. Now, let's go ahead and open up and see what's inside. So, the first thing you're greeted with is the phone on the right and two panels on the left. So let's go ahead and lift up that first panel right there, and you can see the phone is actually really lightweight, and so that's actually pretty cool for a first impression. Now this is going to be IP68 rugged certified with a Helio P3 P23 processor, 4 GB of RAM, 64 GB of internal storage, 13 megapixel Sony sensor, 18:9 ratio, that is 5.5 inches, and NFC on deck. So let's go ahead and take out these two compartments and see what's inside. First one, you get the USB cable, which is cool. So you definitely get a pair of headphones, which is definitely always really good. I was on the internet and I was looking for a phone that I could travel with, take with me in different environments. So this one was definitely a great option because it's waterproof, dust resistant, all that. So let's go ahead and take a look at what's inside here, and you actually get a screen protector for the front. So, it has Gorilla Glass on it. They say that it's an improved Gorilla Glass that is, it meets a high standard of dust resistancy as well, allowing you to continue to work in a dusty and industrial environment, in a sandy environments and stuff like that. So you could bring this to like the beach. I definitely want to, do some traveling soon. So you can see right here, you can actually hold it underwater for 1.2 meters. For 30 minutes, so 1.2 meters for 30 minutes. You can see right here, it actually has seals right here for the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack and for the USB port, so you can actually open those compartments. It's also abominable environment. So basically that means that negative 20 degrees Celsius or 50 degrees Celsius, it's suitable for those types of temperatures. And you can see right here, 30 minutes of immersion of up to 1.2 meters is what they're claiming. You can see the body is really nice. You're getting texture on all the buttons, and on the back is like this carbon fibered, like a carbon fiber type of feel. And you're also getting like texture right here for this button, which is actually going to use to designate the camera to open. So I don't think you can reassign that, but we'll test that out later. And the build is, really good. You're going to be able, you can see you don't even need, SIM remover tool. You could just pop that out. And, we're going to definitely test this underwater. Right there, you can see it holds the two nanos or the SD card and a nano. So let's just go ahead and remove the first front cover right there, put that off to the side, and you should just take a look at that screen. Now, you're not going to get like edge to edge, but you do get the 18:9 ratio for this device. And I wasn't looking for nothing that was too fancy. I just wanted something that would endure temp, you know, like different environments like water. You know, so let's say I was going to go to the beach. I have my phone in my pocket. You know, I'm not going to be swimming or nothing like that, but just in case it gets wet, it's going to be good and I don't have to worry. So this is definitely like a vacation phone. You can see that's like a Tevlar, like a fiber, carbon fiber feeling on the back of there, which is really substantial. It feels really good. You're also getting that headphone jack on the back. You can see the Poptel logo right there on the back, and it does have like a silver color to it, which is pretty cool. And so when you move it in the light, you're gonna see it turns colors, so that's actually cool. I definitely like the build quality, and this thing is really light as well. It's not too heavy or anything like that. So let's go ahead and give it its first boot up right now. So, you know, right here, you could just set it up. Let's just type in the name that it's asking for. And the haptic feedback on this device is really good. That's one of the things I really like. And one hot-handed operation. So I definitely like phones that I could use that are big screens but still give you the ability to use one-handed, and this phone, no exception. So basically right here, I'm gonna set my password or my pattern. Let's get that in there, verify it one more time, and then go ahead, click OK. So after you click OK, you know, you're going to touch that fingerprint sensor, and what you're going to notice is that fingerprint sensor is accurate when you put your finger dead center every single time. And so, you know, I didn't even get any slip-ups right there. Every single time I pressed it, it recognized my finger, so that was actually pretty cool. And so what I came to realize is that in real life, when you use it, it's when you put your finger dead center, it's 100% every single time. So you just want to make sure that it's dead center. And you can see we're getting stock Android. Now this phone later in the video does get an update. Right now you could see that it doesn't have Files Go, but when we update it, it's going to have Files Go, which I love. So you're going to see that it's going to go to the October 5th security patch. Let's just check out the brightness and take a look at how that's going to be looking when you're using it. And I definitely can say that you're going to get some really good screen right here. Now when I first had that phone in my cart, I was like, the 1280 by 6680 was like, you know, I was going to think the screen wasn't suitable and wasn't capable, but looking at it right now, I couldn't even believe this thing wasn't 1080p. On the website, they had a typo and put that the phone was full HD. But when I looked at the specs on a few other websites, it said that the phone was HD. So the screen is really suitable and definitely better than a lot of phones that are actually, you know, HD plus, 720 plus, and some of the 1080 screens I've seen, this one is actually better than. And this phone only has 1280 by, what is it, 680 or something like that. So it's not even up to 720, but you're still getting 720, you know, HD when it, because of the 1280. So right here, you can see outdoor visibility is perfect. No problems there. It's actually really bright and really colorful. So I didn't even know that this thing wasn't full. Like I said before, you can't tell that this thing, the screen looks nice in all angles. And you're not getting any obscurity when you turn it in the light or nothing like that. The software is really nice. It's running 8.1 Oreo right out the box. So you can see right here, there's no problem whatsoever using this thing with one hand. It's snappy, it's quick. And that MediaTek Helio P23, powerful and efficient. So it's going to deliver performance at lightning speeds while consuming 30% less power. So that's going to be the dope part. You're going to notice the difference on this processor paired carefully with optimized software. The P10 can actually work at peak performance even when running many apps at the same time with that 4 gigabytes of RAM. And you can see right here some of the you know, emojis right here. It has an octa-core advanced CPU, and it's an ARM Mali G71 GPU at 2.0 gigahertz frequency. And so that's going to be dope. That's going to be one of the highlights. Now you're going to get the 5.5 HD 18x9 display, which is going to have that full display, offering a really good vivid color saturation on all the photos and all the videos. So, you know, I wasn't going to complain whatsoever. You know, a few times I did take it out my shopping cart, but then once looking at it, I wasn't disappointed, and it's actually better than a lot of phones that I had before that were 720. So this phone is actually suitable for the screen. I definitely give it like an 8 out of 10 in the budget segment. Now let's just take a look at the water test. You know, I'm definitely going to submerge this thing for about 2 minutes, and this thing held up like a champ. So it also does have a Sony IMX 135 camera, which you'll be able to capture really nice video and pictures. It also has a 13 megapixel rear camera with a GCO lens, which is a f2.2, and it also has 80.1 degree of FOV autofocus. So that was actually cool as well, that it had a really good camera, and now it does pair it with NFC. So now let's just take a look, pull that out. You can see, no problem. You know, it wasn't, you couldn't use it underwater, obviously, but once you took it out of water, dried off the buttons, worked perfectly fine. And you can see right out the box, the storage. So now let's just go ahead, test out the camera. So the camera is gonna be pretty good in low light. As you can see, we're gonna just take some pictures and some video so you can check that out. Now, once you get a full feel for this unboxing experience without going into too much detail, because I don't want this video to be too long. So I hope you guys, you know, just stay locked in with me so we can actually go through some of these features. Now, you know, it's still wet, so obviously the touch isn't going to be on point right now. But once it completely dries, everything was completely fine. I was just having a little problem zooming that in, but you can see the quality there. It was really bright, really colorful, really vivid, and there wasn't any problems there. So we're gonna take this thing outdoors and test it out in another video, but just stay tuned right now and stay locked in, because we still got some more footage and some other features to cover. Now this thing does have flash on the front and the back, and you can actually record in 1080 video on the front and back. So the phone, this camera sensors, the Sony sensors were no slouch. So we're going to put that to the test in real life. So stay tuned for that. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel so you can check out more footage on the next video. Also, you do get EIS, image, electronic image stabilization. You can also mess around and adjust the quality of videos from low, medium, or high. And it was automatically set on medium. So, you know, I'm definitely liking what I'm seeing here. And I'm definitely enjoying the P10 so far. So I give that a thumbs up. Now, the software update actually came in after about a day of using it. You know, I was testing out a lot of features. And what I come to find out is that the P23 is powerful and efficient, just like it said. It ran smooth, it flowed smooth and as clean as water. So that was one of the you know, observations when using it. And actually, when I started using it, I didn't want to put it down because of the feel in the hand and just everything. It felt like it already had a case on there, and if I dropped it, I knew that the thing wasn't going to break or anything like that. Military standards, you know, this thing is going to hold up for a long time. I could throw this thing around the room, throw it across the street. You can see the updates coming in. I could just, you know, do anything I want with this thing. You know, it has a gyroscope, also has GPS. The GLONASS, I don't know if you guys know what that is, but the GLONASS plus GPS dual satellite positioning technology allows the P10 to, you know, lead you the right way. You're not going to get lost in some, you know, weird location or nothing like that. The satellite is on point. Also has 4G capability on AT&T and T-Mobile. So all the GSM networks. I'm not sure about Sprint or Verizon or anything like that, because I only mess around with GSMs. So now you can see that the technology It's actually giving you dark mode right here for text messages, and you can actually get that smart response technology on the text message. And now the fingerprint sensor actually lets you use it like a mouse, so it actually lets you navigate through the app tray and through the home screen with the fingerprint like a mouse. Like, that was dope. I never seen that before except on the notification shade on the LG Stylo 4 and a few other phones. I think the Motorola E5 Plus did that on the notification shade. But right here, you can see that I was really, really, really surprised because the P23 didn't stutter not one single time. That thing ran smooth, and especially with the screen being at this, you know, the 1280 by 640 or 680, that efficiency of battery and performance was absolutely, they didn't even lie. That thing ran smooth as butter. Now, you can actually change songs when you just swipe across to the left or right and swipe through your browser with the fingerprint sensor. So this is really cool. I've never seen these features before. Not only that, this thing is dust waterproof, had the NFC feature, which I love on all my daily drivers. So that's actually pretty cool, and I just love how this thing flowed. It was smooth and as clean as water. So let's go ahead. Just to say the least, this thing was surprised. It just surprised me a lot, especially the screen, how colorful it was and bright, and just how the performance for the price that you pay was better than a lot of the phones that I actually get in the US. This phone I did import over from an imported seller. And you just go over to poptelmobile.com and you can check out all the other options they have. But this one seemed like it would be really cool, and it definitely was. Like, I definitely like the build quality. I definitely like the performance. I'm going to test out the cameras more. But I was liking that fingerprint sensor, how you could navigate through every single screen that it actually provided. The fingerprint was really fast. You also get that designated feature to open up the camera. So I just pressed the fingerprint too many times. But look at that designated camera button right there on the left side, also with texture on it. Like a premium solid build on this device, which was tremendous. And, you know, just the fact that they did consider the P10 military quality, you don't have to worry about dropping this thing or throwing it in a puddle of water or in the toilet or anything like that. This thing is going to be a beast, and it's going to be a tank, and it's going to be suitable for any type of environment. If you're like a construction worker, if you just want to take this thing to the beach, if you're a beach bum like me, and you just enjoy going certain places and, you know, not worrying about having to drop your phone or break it, this thing is going to hold up really nicely. And I definitely look forward to doing more tests. Hit the like button if you found it helpful, and I'll see you on the next one. Have a great morning, afternoon, and peace. Have a good night. Make sure you stay tuned for more videos just like this. Hit the like button. I'll check you guys out on the next video. It's your boy Serrano, and make sure you stay locked in. Happy New Year and Merry.